correlation between the music and CrossFit. Obviously, both of what I do is really high intensity. So the techno is pretty full on and CrossFit is really full on. So it's obviously part of my personality and energy that I need something quite demanding, but I've always been that way. It's always all or nothing. One good thing that helps from the CrossFit perspective is the discipline. You know, you have the workouts to do and then you start disciplining yourselves. And I think that then moved into the music and I could be more structured in what I was doing to get things finished and get projects underway and to build up my confidence really to do these things. I don't think that my music is tough, you know, especially my productions. What I play is really tough and it's like this energy and it's not coming from really an aggressive place, it's just coming from like, it's almost an excitable place more than anything. And my productions are slightly less aggressive. So occasionally I can, you know, have a crazy weekend and then make some really hard stuff, but I feel there's a deeper side to me as well, and it's not just always about the bangers. And as an artist, I think it's good to be able to explore the different strains of the music, you know, like if we were just doing one thing over and over again, like that wouldn't make any sense. And just asking yourself, what is coming out of me today? Like, what do I want to make? And just allowing this sort of creativity to come forward is a really nice experience. And I don't always like the pressure of like, oh, I have to make club tracks that are going to be winners for EPs and stuff. But that can become really boring after a time. My skills as a producer are pretty unorthodox. I kind of don't have so many rules. I just use different pieces of kit and it's not really scientific in any way. It's just like, you know, mess around, record things. Does it work? Does it not? And then, you know, I even send things to the mastering engineer and I'm like, I'm sure it's out of tune. And then he sends me like a link back to like a comedy sketch saying it doesn't have to be in tune. And yeah, it's everything is kind of by ear. And you know, like when I was at college, they teach you, you know, don't go over more than 5 dBs and all about the compression. And I think I just use my ears a lot more. I just plan on doing what I do, but obviously aiming to get better in the studio, maybe to use the tools that I have a little bit more refined. So maybe distortion needs to be looked at a little bit better. And, you know, having a big body of work with the album, it then allows me to see where my weaknesses are. You know, the next batch of music, I'm hoping that it will be slightly better produced, but still maintaining what I have with the energy. On a personal level, I'm challenging my demons and I'm still working on stuff. I say I'm like a work in progress. I'm still really into my spirituality and trying to live by those spiritual rules. Don't always get it right, but you know, I'm giving it a good go.